Hey, what's up? This is Anupam. I'll be doing a whole tutorial series of learning the ARM programming on STM32F4 Discovery board. In this series, you will understand what is ARM, how to do programming on chips, what actually is the STM32F4 Discovery board. Basically, this whole video tutorial series will be based on the Discovery board. And from time to time, we'll be creating some cool projects by using this board. You can check out my website www.logicvoltage.com. You'll find these tutorials there also. You can even check out the video store at the website. You'll find very good video tutorial series there with a very less price. People are buying it, talking about it. You can also buy it and I'm sure you'll not be disappointed. You can get in touch with me also in case of inquiry. Just go to contact us page and fill up the form and I will reply. You can check out the forum also. For any tutorial related queries, you can post comment there and I will reply back there so that other people can also see the comment and what discussion is going on. Please make some donations also so that we can continue to create the free tutorials. You are welcome to choose any amount as you like for donation. Will be highly appreciated. Thanks. Okay, now as I mentioned earlier that in this series, you will understand what is ARM, how to do programming on chips, what actually is the STM32F4 Discovery board. But still, before going forward, few basic things you must know. One of the thing is actually what is a microcontroller. I know many of you guys know about it, but still just go on with me for now. A microcontroller is a small computer on a small single integrated circuit containing a processor core, memory and programmable input output peripherals. Microcontrollers are designed for embedded applications. The majority of microcontrollers in use today are embedded in other machinery, such as automobiles, telephones, computer systems. Now, this is just a definition, but in this tutorial series, we'll actually be working on the microcontroller, programming it and using it to create some cool applications. Now, before going forward, there is one more thing that you guys must know, that in market we have many companies that manufactures microcontrollers. One of the most common popular company is ARM. ARM Holdings develops the instruction set and architecture for ARM based products, but does not manufacture products. The company periodically releases updates to its codes. ARM Holdings licenses the chip designs and the ARM instruction set architectures to third parties, who actually design their products that implement one of those architectures. Companies that make chips that implement an ARM architecture include Apple, Atmel, Broadcom, Freescale Semiconductor, Nvidia, NXP, Qualcomm Electronics, Samsung Electronics, STMicroelectronics, Texas Instruments. Globally, ARM is the most widely used instruction set architecture. The low power consumption of ARM processors has made them very popular. Now, there are three most popular ARM architectures which many of you guys know about. One is Cortex-A, second is Cortex-R and the third is Cortex-M. Each has its own unique features. You can choose to use any as per your choice. Generally, in real world, that totally depends on the application you are building on which you'll use the architecture. Now, in each individual Cortex series, we have many other options. Like you can see in my screen, that in Cortex-A we have Cortex-A72, Cortex-A57, A53, A17, A15, A9, A7, A5, and similarly in Cortex-R we have other many options, and Cortex-M also we have M7, M4, M3, M1, M0+, M0. Now this tutorial series will be based on the Cortex-M4 architecture. As I previously mentioned that ARM not actually manufactures these. These are different third party companies that manufactures. So these tutorial series will be based on the STM32F4 Discovery board. This board is from STMicroelectronics company. In this board we have microcontroller having the ARM Cortex M4 architecture. So we'll learn to work and program and debug on this board. Okay, so now we have basic background knowledge. Let's start by first showing you the Discovery board. Okay, this is how the discovery board comes in package. Let's open the package. This is the discovery board. The STM32F4 discovery helps you to discover the STM32F407 chip and to develop your applications easily. It includes everything required for beginners and experienced users to get started quickly. Now, if I talk about the features, it has STM32F407 VGT6 microcontroller, having 32-bit ARM Cortex M4, 1 MB flash memory, 192 KB RAM, and it's the LQFP100 package. This is the microcontroller which I am talking. This is the main microcontroller on which we'll do programming and create applications. Onboard, it has ST-Link V2 with selection mode switch. This will help us to use the ST-Link to use as a standalone programmer also. Now about power supply. You can give power to this board using two ways, either through USB cable or using an external 5-volt power supply that you can give on the pins. You can also supply power to external peripherals like motors or LEDs, but we have only two options here. Either we can supply 3-volt or 5-volt. This board has also micro electromechanical systems, or in short we generally call it MEMS. It's LIS302DL or LIS3DSH, that depends on the version of the discovery board. I have version C, so I have here LIS3DSH, but you could have version V board, so maybe you have LIS302DL here. But don't worry, both versions B and C are nearly the same, so whatever we learn here will work for both. MEMS are generally very small in shape. We'll learn about this in great details in further tutorials. But for now, I can say that these are generally used for sense gravity, acceleration, motion, or tilt direction. One possible real-world use case is in laptops or computers, where it is used to sense free falling. So if somehow you dropped your laptop, then this kind of MEMS chips can easily sense the free fall gravity. And when it is in the mid-air before hitting the ground, it will lock the hard disk and save it from the damage. This board has 4 LEDs here, red, green, blue and orange. These are placed here so that we can easily start testing and working on this board. You will use them in many future tutorials to learn ARM programming. We have 2 push buttons here, user push button and reset button. Reset button is used to reset the board. What actually means resetting here, that we will learn later. And the user button is for general purpose use. We can use this button for our testing. I will show you how to work with this in later tutorials. And then you can see that we have extension header pins all over this board. These pins are actually connected to the pin on this microcontroller. So it's because very easy for us to connect external peripherals to this chip by using these header pins. There are many other useful things in this board, and from time to time in future tutorials I will show you what's the use and how to use. Okay, so now we have some background knowledge about most of the things. But before we can start here, there is a list of few other things that you should have in hand to start programming this board. Well, from the hardware point of view, you need first is obviously this board itself. You need to have a USB type A to mini B USB cable that will connect your board to computer or laptop, whatever you have. And then we have a breadboard. These are generally used for prototyping. We need few connecting wires like this. This one is female to female header pin, and this one is male to male. Few LEDs. Although we have 4 LEDs already present in the board, but still we need these. I'll tell you why in later part when we'll use this. Few buttons like this. These are push buttons. Okay, for now this much is fine to get going with the tutorials, and in future tutorials if anything more needed I will tell you from time to time. Although these things are easily available and you can get near some electronic store. Well, from hardware point of view this much is fine, but now we need some software also. This software is through which we make programs, compile them and then run and debug. To program this board we have few options to choose. We have Altium tasking toolset as you can see in my screen. Other option we have is Atolic True Studio. Then third option we have IAR Embedded Workbench. And one more option we have is Kyle MDK ARM. So we have four softwares here, and in this tutorial series we'll use the Atolic True Studio. Well, this is just a personal choice. You can choose use any other also, as long as you know how to write code and compile it. You can get the light version of Atolic True Studio and install on your system. Light version is free. After installing it, it will ask you to register yourself to activate the product. Just do it and activate it. After installation and activation, Atolic True Studio will look like this, as you can see in my screen. In the light version there is some limitation, but for this tutorial series it will work. Before going forward, one more thing that you should know, that we'll be using the C programming language. So you should know about that language and how to write programs. Although you don't have to be expert in the C language, but still few basic concepts about general programming you should know. After we have done all these things, we are good to go now and start working on the STM32F4 Discovery board. Okay, so enough talking, let's directly dive into it. Okay, so when you have purchased this board and received it, the first time you connect this board to a computer, you will see some LEDs are blinking. That's because initially from company, the board was programmed with a demo project. Okay, so here I am connecting this USB cable to the Discovery board and the other part to my computer. Okay, so see what will happen when I connect this board to the computer. So I'm now connecting to it. You can see now these LEDs are blinking. This is programmed like this in the board. Now if I push the user button once, and it will change the pattern. See? So now what happened is that it goes into the tilt sensing mode. What that means is, see that I'm tilting the board and the LED will start blinking. The more I'm tilting it, the LED speed, the blinking speed will increase. You can see that LED starts blinking it in the direction of the tilt. This is also micro USB connector. If you connect it to a computer, then you can control your computer's mouse also with this board. This is also an audio and recording demo that also you can test. The details you can also get it from ST website. They have proper documentation on how to run the demo project. That's all part of demo project, telling you that what you can do with this board. Okay guys, so now we have some basic background knowledge of most of the things, and so we will start writing code and programming the board from the next tutorial. Once again, this is Anupam from logicvoltage.com, and thanks for watching. Bye.